This is the flag of the United States of America. It is a nation that was built by the work of immigrants desperate for a shot at the American dream. Many of these workers took their shot at the pursuit of happiness in northeastern Pennsylvania. And when people think about northeastern Pennsylvania, there was one city that comes into their mind, and that is the city of Scranton. The city of Scranton is rich with history, traditions, customs, and cultures that span from the breaker boys of the anthracite coal mines to the vice president of the United States. The immigrant workers of Scranton all shared one common connection, which was a love for food. Food was used as a tool for sparking memories of, as the Italian-American worker would say, the old country. This rich history of such a deep love for food inspired me to seek out Scranton's present-day ethnic cuisine and see if any of that same devotion is in the kitchens of today. The first style of food I chose to seek out and eat was Mexican. In America today, the number one migrant worker is of Mexican descent, so I decided to look for where he eats in Scranton today, and I found Don Pancho Villa. I spoke with the owner of the restaurant, who did not speak any English, and her daughter, who was my waitress, translated for us. I asked her to pick out a traditional meal that a person of Mexican descent would most likely order. Next, I asked her to tell me why she cooks and if she loves what she does. She said she loves to cook and loves what she does. She stated how everything that is served in her restaurant is fresh and all made on location. She said she takes pride in starting the day at 7 a.m. and working all day long. She was also very happy to provide a place where members of Scranton's Mexican community could come and feel as if they were home. They could come there and eat the food that would bring them back to wherever it was they were before. The next ethnic restaurant that I decided to eat at is called Cafe Classico and is owned by my new good friend, Bino.
A boy went back to Napoli because he missed the scenery, the native dances and the charming songs. But wait a minute, something's wrong, 'cause now it's
Mambo, Mambo Italiano, hey Mambo, Mambo Italiano, go, go, go. You mixed up a Siciliano, all you Calabrese do the Mambo like a crazy with a hey Mambo. Don't wanna tarantella, hey Mambo, no more mozzarella, hey Mambo. Mambo Italiano, try an angelada with the fish bacala.
When I informed Pino that I was doing a project that involved his restaurant, he was very delighted and very helpful. But when I told him my grandmother was from Naples, he offered to take me back to the kitchen and show me around, pay for my whole dinner, and then he sat with me for almost the entire meal. Over the course of the meal, we discussed many different things. But one thing that stuck out was his reason for coming to America. I asked him why he came. He looked around and quietly whispered, "Gomorrah," and assuming I didn't know what he was talking about, then whispered, "Mafia." The topic of conversation that we spoke about the most was Pino's passion for cooking. He repeated to me multiple times that he cooks with his heart. He said it gives him joy to see people come from a hard day's work and leave happy and leave full. He is a very passionate person, and he is devoted to his cooking, his family, his staff, which he considers to be a part of his family, and most of all, Italy. The next location where I decided to eat was Abe's Delicatessen, which is a kosher establishment in downtown Scranton. I had the opportunity to speak with the owner of Abe's and ask him a few questions about being an ethnic restaurant of such importance to its community. He spoke about how proud he was to be Jewish and how happy he was to operate a kosher deli. He was very pleased to give me a traditional meal filled with things like hummus, baba ganoush, and most significantly, lox. He pointed out how committed they are to keeping things kosher, that even the menu is split right down the middle, with dairy products on the left and the meat products on the right. Abe's is a cornerstone of the Jewish community in Scranton, and it too, like Cafe Classico and Don Pancho Villa, is operated with the same passion for cooking and food that its immigrant forefathers brought during the time when coal was king. My final selection for ethnic cuisine in the Scranton area was Thai Rock Thai. This restaurant, although excellent, was not operated with the same ethnic feel as all the other places that I visited. The location was least receptive to my project. However, the food was still excellent and my dishes were very traditional and were even some of the things that are often eaten in the home of someone from Thai descent. This trip through Scranton's ethnic cuisine brought me knowledge, laughter, joy, fun, food, and sadness. The only sadness I happened to receive was from my conversation about chain restaurants and how their advertising is attempting to push out local restaurants. These ethnic restaurants are not what Scranton is built on. And as the culture and ethnic backgrounds of people from the past continue to mix and fade, there's a fear in my heart that these types of passionate chefs and owners will disappear until we are left with only Olive Garden for Italian and Taco Bell for Mexican. But for now, the food of the past still remains, and it needs to be appreciated, loved back, and most importantly, eaten.
Just what makes that little old ant think he'll move that rubber tree plant? Anyone knows an ant can't move a rubber tree plant, but he's got